Welcome to another video on factoring trinomials. This video will discuss how to factor a trinomial when the leading coefficient a does not equal 1. We'll talk about how to factor trinomials using the trial and error method, and also how to use the grouping technique. I will cover how to factor a trinomial using a method called bottoms up in another video. Let's first talk about how to use the trial and error method, and please keep in mind we'll only use these new methods when the leading coefficient a is not equal 1 or when it cannot be factored out. So what we'll do is we'll place the factors of ax squared in the first positions of the two sets of parentheses that represent the factors. Then we'll place two possible factors of c into the second positions of the parentheses. Then we'll find the inner and outer products of the two sets of parentheses, and we'll keep doing this until we find the inner and outer products that add to the middle term bx. So if you know your multiplication tables really well, you might like this method. If you want a step-by-step process that always works, this may not be the best method for you. So let's go ahead and give this trial and error method a try. If we want to factor this trinomial, we start off by setting up a set of parentheses. The first terms in each factor must consist of the factors of 6x squared. So it could be 6x and x or 3x and 2x. I'm going to go ahead and try the 3x and the 2x. Next, we look at the factors of positive 15 and place them in the second positions. Again, we don't know if we should use 1 and 15 or 3 and 5. That's why it's called the trial and error method. But they do have to be factors of positive 15. So let's say I decide to put the 3 here and the 5 here. Since I'm using two positive factors, I'd have to use plus signs. Now right away, I'm concerned here because we're never going to have common factors in a binomial if there weren't any common factors in the original trinomial. But let's go ahead and test it. And the test is check the inner product and the outer product and see if the sum is the middle term of negative 19x. We have 21x. So those are the wrong factors. So a trial and error method means that. Just try something different. So let's go ahead and set this up again. And I still like the factors of 6x squared as 3x and 2x. But let's go ahead and switch the 5 and the 3 around. Let's put the 5 here this time and the positive 3 here this time. Let's check our inner and outer product. Now we have a 10x plus 9x, which equals 19x. Now this is actually pretty good. We have a positive 19x. We want a negative 19x. But that's actually a pretty easy fix. We know that 5 times 3 equals 15, but so does negative 5 times negative 3. So let's try 3x minus 5 times 2x minus 3. Let's check our products. Now we have a negative 10x and a negative 9x, which would give us the negative 19x that we need. So through trial and error, we have found the factors of that trinomial. So if you didn't find this process pleasing, you may prefer the grouping technique. But let's go ahead and try one more. Let's go ahead and set up our parentheses, which represent our binomial factors. The first terms must consist of the factors of 15x squared. So let's try 5x and 3x. Of course, it could be 15x and 1x. We just don't know. Next, the second positions must come from the factors of negative 42. Some of the factors of negative 42 would be negative 7 times 6, negative 6 times 7, negative 14 times 3, negative 3 times 14. How do we know which factors to use? Well, we don't. We just try two of them. That's why it's called trial and error. However, the more you do this, the better you get at it. So if we tried, let's say, the minus 7 here, then this would have to be plus 6. Well, let's check it. Here we have 18x, and the outer product would be negative 35x, which equals negative 17x. Again, we have the wrong sign, but the right number. And again, that's a very easy fix. Just switch the signs. Instead of using the positive 6, let's use the negative 6 here. And instead of using the negative 7, we'll use the positive 7. So this would essentially change the sign of these two terms, which would change the sign of the sum, and we have found our winner. Now I've been doing this for quite a while, and I have a little more experience, so I can find these rather quickly. And if you can too, this will probably be the best method for you. But if you want a different method to use, let's try the grouping technique. And here's what we'll do. First, we notice that A is not a common factor, so what we do is we find the product AC. Then we list the factors of AC that add to B. Then we rewrite BX as a sum or difference of the factors of AC that added to B. And then we use the grouping technique. Now, if you don't remember the grouping technique, you may want to review the video entitled Factor by Grouping. Okay, so let's try this new method. Step one, we need to find A times C. Well, A times C would be 9 times 4, which equals 36. So now our question is, what are the factors of 36 that add to negative 15? Let's list a few and see if we can find it. Negative 4 times negative 9. These would have a sum of negative 13. Close, but not what we need. Next, we might try negative 18 times negative 2. That would be negative 20. That's not what we want. And I think we can find it if we multiply negative 12 times negative 3. This multiplies to positive 36 and adds to negative 15. What we do is we use these two factors to rewrite the middle term. So what that means is we write 9x squared. Instead of minus 15x, we're going to write minus 12x minus 3x. It's still minus 15x plus 4. But now we factor this by grouping, so we're going to cut it in half, factor out the GCF of the first two terms. That would be 3x. We're left with 3x minus 4. Now, the second two terms only have a common factor of 1 or negative 1. Remember, we're looking for another binomial factor of 3x minus 4. If we factored out a negative 1, we'd have a positive 3x, and then instead of plus 4, we'd have minus 4, which is good news. We have a common binomial factor. So our last step, if we factor out the common binomial factor of 3x minus 4, we're left with 3x minus 1. And we have factored the original trinomial using the grouping technique. Let's go ahead and try another one. First, we notice that 10 is not a common factor, so we multiply A times C. A times C would be 10 times negative 12, which would equal negative 120. We want to find the factors of negative 120 that add to 7. Again, not a very easy question. One factor is going to be negative, one will be positive. Let's just try some of these. Negative 40 times 3, that would work, but that's obviously not going to give us a sum of positive 7. If we tried negative 10 times 12, that would be a sum of positive 2. That won't work. But if we tried negative 8 times positive 15, that would give us a sum of positive 7. So those are the two winning factors. One thing that I find helpful when I'm trying to find these factors is use the prime factorization of 120. This is what I mean by that. If I take 120, break it up into 12 times 10, and 12 would be 2 times 2 times 3, and 10 would be 2 times 5, I can play around with the prime factorization to come up with these factors. But it's not an easy task. Okay, let's rewrite this as four terms so we can use grouping. So we'll have 10x squared. Again, instead of 7x, we will use these two factors to write it as minus 8x plus 15x minus 12. Cut it in half and use grouping. So the GCF of these two terms would be 2x. We'd be left with 5x minus 4. And then here we have a common factor of just 3. So we'd have 5x minus 4, which is good news because we have that common binomial factor again. So we can complete the factoring by factoring out the 5x minus 4, and we'd be left with 2x plus 3. So these problems are quite a bit of work, but they are manageable if you take it step by step.